Trinity Harvest family. Welcome to the Grace Fasting and Prayer Devotional. My name's Shelby, and I have a word to share with you today about God's grace. So go ahead and grab your Bible, and let's go to Romans chapter 6, verse 14. Got it? You're straight? Let's go. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law, but under grace. So this verse is found in perhaps the most complete book in the New Testament that really explains the core of our beliefs. And in this letter to the Romans, the Apostle Paul is sharing with them his picture. And in this picture, we see that God's faithfulness is revealed through salvation found in Christ, okay, found in his life, his death, and his resurrection. And this salvation is available for any and everyone who would have faith in him, who would believe. So whether they were Jew or Gentile, or fast forward to 2023, and they're black or white, short, tall, Republican, Democrat, vegan, non-vegan, it doesn't matter. It is available to everybody. And what Paul shares with the original readers is that through God's grace, through this free and unmerited favor, they were redeemed into a true and right relationship with God. And the same applies to us today. Those of us who believe, who have accepted Christ as Lord and Savior, we too are redeemed into this right relationship with God. We are dead to sin, and we are alive to the Lord. And of course, the enemy, being as he is, he doesn't want that to happen. He wants us to forget this. And the reason why is because he wants us to forget that Christ broke the yoke of sin slavery over us. He wants us to forget that sin does not have dominion over us. And so basically, he really wants us to stay under his thumb, to remain under his control. But what he does not get, even after all this millennia, is that the gift of God's grace is higher, bigger, deeper, and more powerful than any sin from past, present, or the future. Okay? God's grace is more powerful than our nunchuck choices that we've made that were running contrary to God's will or that were harmful to other people or ourselves. His grace is more powerful than our wayward thoughts and our vain imaginations, and it's more powerful than our selfish, self-serving actions. This gift, this precious, this powerful gift that we did not work for, that we did not earn, and let's be truthful, we ain't qualified to receive it. God gave it to us anyhow because he loves us and because he wants to accomplish something through us, through and for our lives. So this gift, we got to remember that it overrules sin, that it completely dominates it. And as we remember this, as we remember that we are under grace, we can better honor God with how we live. So what do I mean? I mean our walking, our talking, our living, our thinking, our doing, all of that is to honor him. We basically live like we got some sense, and specifically like we got some God sense, reflecting his love and his glory to his creation. And, because there's always an and sharing with other people who don't yet know God, that he sees them, he hears them, and he loves them, and that he wants to be in right relationship with them too. So no matter how the enemy tries to convince otherwise, sin does not have dominion over us. It has no sovereignty, and it does not have the power to force us back into servitude, because through Christ by faith, we are under God's grace. So let us pray. Thank you, God, for your redemptive power. Thank you that you have brought us back into right relationship and fellowship with you, and that we are not slaves to sin, that we are not under its dominion. Father God, I pray that your grace reigns and rules over our lives each day. And because of that, Lord, remind us that we can live free. I ask, God, that you renew and remind us daily to live for you, that we reflect your goodness and your mercy wherever we go, so that those who don't know you may see the God in us and ask, what must I do to be saved? I ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.